And it's a voice hearer. Some people might have experienced hearing voices, or people who hear voices. For a lot of people, voice hearing can be kind of an intense experience. I'm not sure what your experience is. Maybe they just spend 1 minute talking to the person beside you about what you think voice hearing is about. Take it away. As Paddy engages with voices and engages with the system.
Okay, so it was just freezing the picture there. So there's Paddy's journey so far, engaging with the system. How do you think he's getting on? He's not?
No.
Anyone any ideas? What's his main problem? What do you think?
Too much medication.
Too much medication. Medication is?
There's no medication at all. It's just
no. Yeah, so he's asked for help, and we've got a series of interventions here. It's purely medical, is that it?
Yeah, there's no communication between doctors.
And there's no talk. Anyone else? Any other?
He doesn't have a clue.
He doesn't have a clue. Are you talking about the medical profession or Paddy?
Oh, no, the medical profession.
The medical profession hasn't a clue on how to deal with someone like this.
Not in that
way. Anyone else? Any other?
He's still there, bearing down.
Sorry?
What's going on for him is still there, it's still very dynamic.
It's still there, it's just getting buried by a few layers now, so it's still there.
It's visually, it's still surrounding him and on top of him almost. At least before the medication, he was upright and communicating.
Yeah, he had a bit of fight in him before the medication.
Yeah. He's not conforming with society.
Yeah, so he's not fitting in.
And the people that are medicating him are sick themselves, are probably more than he is.
Right, that's a fairly strong opinion. They're worse than idiots. Yeah.
I don't know much about schizophrenia, but I don't think the voices ever go. I think they're with you for life.
They're with you for life. Okay.
Right, well, that's great. So look, we're going to run on and we're going to have a closer look at Paddy's journey. And just hold on to your thoughts, and we're going to have a few more words about it in a few minutes when we see the rest of the sketch. So, whenever you're ready, action.
Thank you.
So yeah, but didn't it seem like, I don't know, looking at there, didn't it seem like Paddy started that journey himself rather than the system? Yeah. Did that seem like that to you? Yeah. So this is a hugely fearful situation, what was going on with Paddy. A hugely fearful thing.
They physically touched for the first time.
Yeah. Eye contact here with the profession, physical touch, and the kind of help on a human level rather than a professional level.
It would be random, wouldn't it, if you were talking to see somebody's eyes looking to yours and for them to actually touch it and say, "I'm here."
Although it seemed like a really conscious internal decision that Paddy took with courage to stand up and not knowing what was going to be the consequence, to say, "I'm not taking this, I'm not taking these drugs, I'm not taking this system." And then a conscious decision to call in the voice of light or the voice of support, and then to use that voice as like the anchor to turn into face and to befriend the other voices.
Yeah, that's a huge act of courage, though outside the norm probably, is it? To turn down medication, and that is